Holy shit. What happened? 1, 2, 4. Hello and welcome to part 2 of our motion graphic video tutorial thing. And in this part I would like to show you guys how to go further with your animation. In the last video we did a desktop that was growing and a PC that was popping up, and in this video I'd like to show you guys how to log in, how to do the login part. I will show you guys in this video, so let's see what I'm talking about. Like the login, and then it says welcome and some kind cool emotions going on, and I would like to show you guys how I did this. So the first thing I did with our last project is I've selected all these layers and then go to layer pre-compose. So in that case it's much cleaner than when you have all these layers messing around. And well, let's go to part 2 right now. So first thing we are going to do is we have to copy the exact same color as the screen. I already did this, so I just have to go to layer, new solid, and I'll put in my screen color. It already got the color, and press OK and drop it beneath the texture and grunge, so you can see it's exactly the same color as the screen. So Ctrl Z, get it centered. Now we are going to click rename this one to login background, and now go to layer and pre-compose, and we will call this one a login. Move all attributes. Okay. Now we can mask our login screen, so we are going to our main composition and then we will scale this one down to exactly the same size as our screen. So let me get it at an exact same size. Maybe just use your arrow keys to go one pixel left or one pixel right and make sure it's perfectly the same size as the screen, like this. Now we can go to our animation, like here when the screen is at full size, like this. And then we will cut off our login composition. So when the time indicator is in front of it, it is not appearing right here. So now we can just zoom in. And with that part, I've used a null object. Right click new null object. And you have to link the login and the intro composition to the null object. And just right click and call the null object zoom in. So now we can just press S for scaling, click on the watch and go with your time indicator to, I don't know how fast it goes, but maybe a half second, and just increase till it's full size, like this. And we go back with the time indicator to the first keyframe, press P for positioning, and then we will go on pressing U to see all the keyframes, and then sometimes you have to press twice. Go to the last keyframe and we will position it a little bit to beneath, under. So now it's perfectly filling our screen. So as you can see, it zooms in right this way. You can add some motion blur, but I'm leaving it this way. To add motion blur, you just have to click on these settings and make sure it's put on. So it's enabled, but I will leave it that way. So there we go, that was zoom. Maybe we have to ease it, just to give a little bit more motion graphic look to it. Make sure it's both selected, both easy ease. To the left, a little bit to the right, and let's see how fast it goes. There we go, that's a very awesome zoom in. So the next part we had to do is get that cool thumbnail with this login text on it. So I'm going to import a file Let's go to my motion graphic part to editor icon. I will import the mobile phone as well. Nope, I will go to import the event. I will get footage, merge, alright. And I will drag it into our main composition and make sure it is centered. If you don't have the tracker, the window on the right, just go to window and click on tracker. Not tracker, but we have to use align. Excuse me for that. So yes, put it a little bit to the top. Shift arrow key above so it goes faster, and we will get a cool turbulence displacement on it. Just drag it onto the layer. And we need a click on to your layer so it's not selected. We have to create a rectangle shape a little bit larger than the thumbnail itself, like this, something like this. Put it beneath the editor and we will give it a stroke. Give it a white stroke, and we will give it a 5 pixel stroke. Nope, we give it a 6 pixel. Press S. A little bit larger. Something like this. And we are putting the fill option to off. So press OK. And now we can animate the thumbnail itself. So go to our last keyframe, something like 6 seconds. And we are going to open up our shape layer, add a trim path for the stroke. Set it to 100%. Start a little bit further, the time indicator. Not too far, and we will set it to 0%. If we turn off our avatar, let's see how it looks. So there we go. A little bit too fast, and we have to give it a little bit of an easy ease. So always use an easy ease. So there we go. Nice and clean. A little bit earlier, so let's render again. Nice, there it goes. So finally we have to get it on the avatar icon in we have to get the avatar icon on it. So that is appearing right here. So let's give it, cut it off. Let's go to this arrow to effect to a turbulence displacement, and we will turn on the amount, complexity, evolution, and the size itself. And let's go a little bit further again with your time indicator and make sure to hit all these keyframes. And the amount is at the end 0, of course, so it's not misformed. And go to our first keyframes and just increase the amount to a very large value, maybe 1000. Size should be also very huge, 300. Complexity should be something about 2. The evolution should be, I don't know, just mess around with these settings and it will give you a cool look. And let's watch the render. So that was very fast, so just select the keyframes, move it a little bit to the right. Maybe you have to easy ease them, I don't know how that looks like. Sometimes it doesn't look right, so. But we can always check it, so we just click on it and drag the keyframes to the left in the graph editor. So let's look at it again. So that looks better. a little bit fast, a little bit more to the right. So let's look at it again. So that looks good. So let's turn off our that arrow, so give it a clean look at it. So we can now log in our screen. We have to put a password on it, as I did in the video. So to do that, just duplicate or shake, set it above, Control D. Just get it a little bit to the bottom. Make sure our anchor point is in the middle. Something like this. Just drag it a little bit, like a password. Like a password form. Like this. And it also got the same animation already, so we don't have to worry about that again. So let's look how that looks like. As you can see, we've got some weird width on the right, and that's because we have scaled it a little bit wrong. So let's get that done by just delete that, this one, just create a new one, it's just messed up because it's scaled wrong. Just drag another one, make sure it's centered a little bit to the bottom. Cut it out, and let's open shape layer 1 and copy the keyframes. So now we can click on shape layer 2, paste it, and it got the same animation without these weird borders. And just set it a little bit to the right so it's logging in when a thumbnail was appearing already. So final thing we have to do is get these plugin dots, and I did that very cheap way. Just get a little lips, make sure the stroke is turned off, give it a fill, I will give it a white fill, and just drag some ellipses. Make sure the anchor point is in the middle. For some reasons it always put the anchor point in the center of a composition, but just drag them into our ellipse and just duplicate the ellipse itself. Control D, just drag them a little bit to the right. Control G, D again a little bit to the right. And just do that multiple times. I think you guys got the idea. I'm not doing a lot of dots, so I will stay at 6. And just select them all. Click on them all, and I will drag them into our password composition, password area. It's a little bit a large area, but that doesn't matter. You get the idea. So it's logging in when it's about 6.5 seconds. Let's cut them all off, and the only thing you have to do is drag them just a few frames from each other. I don't know exactly how much frames. I'm now going for 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. But I think that is a little bit too short, but let's see. So now we can watch how fast that goes. Click on B for cutting this render area off. And that looks very weird. Holy shit. Some of these ellipses are not at the right position. Like these two guys. Oh god. I don't know what happened, but for some reason it is messing around with my project. So, like these two guys, I think. Holy shit. What happened? 1, 2, 4? 4, 5? Like these two guys should be above. Ah! Shape 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now it's at the right position, but not at the right timing. So now it's fixed. I guess. Let's see. Whoa, that goes very fast, so let's increase it a little bit. So let's see again. Well, I think that's okay for now. So, just select the ellipse and all this, all these layers, and I'll select them all, and I will pre-compose them all to plug in. So now we've got a nice clean composition, and I will cut the composition a little bit earlier, so I'll cut it out and I will give it a motion blur, and I will show you guys why. Maybe just go into make sure it's all selected, all these motion blurs, and let's go with our main composition, and now we can just get this text effect like I did with the login and welcome stuff. So let's get to our new knowledge check and to the keyframe where it should disappear. So I think that's something like here, cut the knowledge off, zoom out a little bit. I've given it a position, but first I'm going to link our login to our knowledge. And I'll give given this a position, and now I can just simply move my login composition to the right, and as you can see, it got a nice motion blur on it. So it moves to the right, maybe a little bit too slow. So maybe a little bit faster. So there we go. And the next thing is we have to create that login screen. So I will give it a cool new text. And I will give it a login. Well, it's a little bit huge. Set it more to 150. That's alright, I will make sure it's sent. And I will cut it off as well. And I will put this login text at the left of my composition. I will make sure that it's got a motion blur. And I will link this one to the null object as well. And as you can see, it's just moving. But we go to a last keyframe of the null object. And then we will move our text to the center of the composition. So now it is, as you can see, stopping right in the center. And we will give it an easy of course as well. Move it to the right. Easy ease. And now it looks like this. So now we are logged in. Oh well, we are logging in. Just give it some cool dots, some ellipses after the login word. Just Ctrl D, make sure it is again at the right of the first ellipse. I hope it is working right now. So we've got ellipse 1, 2, 3, yep, that's working fine. And they are appearing something like here. So do exactly the same as our password, just move these dots a little bit to the right. I don't know how this looks like, just render it out to get a preview of our work. That looks okay, but it's a little bit too fast. I will drag it a little bit to the right. So, or maybe you have a very fast computer where you log in very fast, but cut our render area a little bit to the right. I only have to see how a login works. So let's see again. Yep, that's okay. So now we have to create that welcome look alike thing I did in a video. I don't have the video right here, but the thing I did is, first of all, we have to get away these dots. So we just press T, first select the ellipse layers, press T, and then go to just move time again to 9 seconds, something like this. Press the opacity on and go to 10 seconds and set it to 0. So now watch how fast that goes. Oh, that's a little bit too slow. Okay, let's go faster. Well, that's okay. Make sure to save before After Effects is crashing. Now we are going to get that welcome text in front of our login. The I and the N is forming a W from welcome. How I did that is basically easy. Just duplicate our login text, and I will give it another color, so this, so I can see what I'm doing. And I will just delete these two letters at the end and just make sure it's right at the same position as these first letters from login. So something like this. And we are just going to create a shape or with a pencil, and we are just making the ears exactly the same size as the I and the N from the text itself. So now I've got a shape that's exactly the same. Well, it's not exactly the same, but it's almost the same. Get this anchor point in the middle. Make sure it is the same. Gosh, why are you not working? I don't want a mask on my... That's why you have to make sure you don't select any other object first, because if you are doing that, it's creating a mask, and we don't need masks. We just have to make sure we have not selected anything. Just click on something like this, so we don't have selected these ellipses or other layers, because if you are working with a pencil and you have selected something, it's making a mask. So make sure you don't have selected anything, and now we can create a shape. So you can see it's creating a new layer, and just make sure it's the same size as our letter. So now you can see it's the same, exactly the same as our eye. So now drag an anchor point in the middle, and we have to do exactly the same to our N. So now we have two shapes the same size as our letters. Now I will cut this one off, and the thing is, now we can animate them. I will call this one, I'm a little bit confused, so I will call this one dot blue, and now I will give this one a white color. There we go. So when it is logging in, it should form a W. So now so you are cutting off our login title, cut it off, and we make sure our login itself is appearing at that moment, and that goes exactly for the same as for our shape. So now we've got, when we are moving our time indicator, you can see, well, we have to put our opacity back to 100%, of course. So now we have two shapes and a lock title text layer, and our other text layer is gone. So basically we can animate these two shape layers right now. Just go to create a new text or just duplicate or log text, and we will set it to welcome. There we go. And just give welcome a red color so we can see how the W how the shape from the W is. So let's get it at the right position, something like this. And now just go to, we've got welcome, something like here, when our log is appearing, or when the dot are disappearing, something like this. And go to your shape, bold, and go to contents, nope, transform, we have to go to transform. Oh, I'm talking a little bit wrong, we have to go to a shape, that's what we have to do. Go to path, and make sure the watch from the path is selected, you as well. And just select both layers and press U, so it's a little bit clean what we are doing. And we can now animate the pad itself, and the time indicator, the timeline is making sure it got from keyframe 1 to the other keyframe, and make sure it's going from shape to shape. So we have to make sure it's a little bit like a half second. And we are going to animate our body eye first, and let's click on the shape, and we can animate guy. It's always very weird working with shapes. So now it is forming the part from the W. And do it exactly the same to our N. I'm doing it a little bit rough and fast, but you get the idea what I'm doing. So I will speed this up a little bit. So as you can see, our shapes are now forming a W. It's not perfect, you can see some red behind it, but it's okay for now, it's just a tutorial. I will click to welcome, and I will give it a white color again. So now we can animate it. Make sure that welcome is turned off. So now we can make sure at the time our I and the N are forming a W, we have to give log a opacity keyframe so it goes from 100% to 0. So when it's forming a W, log is also disappearing. And we have to make sure welcome is appearing, so let's give welcome, let's make sure the W itself is going away, and Lcom is a little bit to the right, and at the same time Lcom is appearing. So it goes from 0 to 100. Now you can see we've got from our login to welcome. So there we go. We can animate a null object to it. Let's go layer new null object. And give it a position. We will link our shape and Elcom to the null object. So just click onto a last keyframe and go to align and set it to center. But it doesn't work that way, just Control Z, excuse me. Just drag the X axis to somewhere you think the center is. You can see a arrow in the middle, that's the center. So make sure our word welcome is in the center. So now you can see it's changing, and there is a welcome. Well, the last part I did in the video was the screen. Was the screen zooming out and forming a mobile with some text on it. I can show you guys fast how that works. It's a little bit the same as what we've done with our computer screen zooming in, but instead of zooming in, we are just zooming out. So we've got a welcome. Well, now I'm going to rename my com to mobile zoom out, and I will create a new composition, new comp, and I will call it main. I will set this composition settings, the duration a little bit to 1 minute 15, and I will drag our mobile zoom out composition into our main composition. And I'm making sure I'm going to import a file, or mobile file. I will put the file in the description. And I'll make sure it is rotated 90 degrees and it's scaled up so it's filled the whole screen. And I will go to where welcome is appearing, something like this. And I will make a null object. Where are you? Null. And I will set a scaling and a rotation on it. Just move the time indicator. Link mobile and mobile zoom out to the null object. And just scale it down. Don't worry about these spaces. I will show you guys how to fix that. And rotate the mobile to like this and scale it down. Excuse me. Scale down something like 30%. And we have to make sure our welcome is a little bit larger. Like 110%. So now you can see your mobile is, it's now just forming a mobile. So that's basically it, and you can just ease it, or you can just give it a cool background behind it, like another color. I don't know, I've used cyan, I don't know what color I've used. And you can just add some text on it, like it's a portfolio, portfolio video. Just very easy animation. I hope you guys liked it. It was a little bit of a long tutorial. That's because I've used a lot of effects on it. I had skipped some parts for you guys, and I had speeded up some parts because otherwise the tutorial is getting so long. And well, I know in my experience, I don't like watching tutorials that are like 30 or 40 minutes. So that's why I'm always going around 20 or 25, but excuse me for that. In the future I will make sure the tutorials, and I hope you guys understand it. If you've got any questions about it, just ask in the comments. I would like to give you some other videos as well about motion graphics. There is coming a very nice tutorial, I'm working on it, and that's a cool title intro tutorial with motion graphics, of course. Well, that's basically it. I hope you guys liked it. Make sure to subscribe and hit thumbs up, and I will see you guys.